This week's review, I'm going to be covering the pay-per-view, Raw and SmackDown. This is probably going to be a long video, so let's get started. So we have Asuka versus Becky for the SmackDown title, women's title. It's a pretty good match. It was good. I obviously knew who it was obvious who was going to win. I wanted Becky to win, but Asuka was going to win. So yeah, as I said, I wanted Becky to win. After the match was over, Becky had stopped and then was planning something in her head on what she's going to do. Because she lost the match, but she still wanted to be in WrestleMania. So she thought. So she's probably thinking to enter the Royal Rumble. Stay tuned. If you didn't watch the pay-per-view, I will get into this. We had The Miz and Shane versus The Bar for the tag team titles. The Miz and Shane won, so now they're tag team champions. So, sorry if I'm looking down, I have my notes written down. Next one, we had Ronda versus Sasha. I wanted Sasha to win, but obviously Ronda was going to win. So, they put on a very awesome match. I enjoyed it. Yes, there might have been some sloppy stuff, but it's fine, whatever. Sasha put her strap thing that she has right here and put it in her mouth like this and pulled during the bank statement, pulled Ronda back, all that. Then once the match is over, Sasha walks away and then turns right back around, goes over there, shakes Ronda's hand, and then does this, which to me, when she does it, it's kind of like she's giving somebody the middle finger, like just goes like this. It's kind of like flipping Ronda off. But it's the horsewoman's sign. I'm trying to go through this fast. I don't want it to be too long because then it'll take forever to edit. So I'm trying. We had a women's Royal Rumble match. And we had some people. None of these is who I really wanted to make an appearance, you know. We had some NXT stars. I don't know how to pronounce some of these names, so I'm just going to probably put a text right here on who they are. But then we had some, I'll put those there. And then we had Maria Kanellis. She doesn't even belong there, honestly. She's not even part of the women division, so I don't even know why she's not even. I don't know. I wish they would pick somebody better. A couple of these people, I wish they picked somebody better. We had Candice, we had Casey, we had Rhea. I think that's how you pronounce it. So we had those women enter. Lana was coming out in the ring. She was limping really slow, blah, blah, blah. It's totally fake. And then Becky Lynch came out. Well, we had some guys helping. Becky Lynch comes out. And was basically wanting to enter a Rumble. She was like, basically wanted to take her place. They eventually said yes, Becky went in there. Did all their things. Becky ended up winning the Royal Rumble. So that was pretty good. That's what she was planning. So she won it. And yeah. So and then she will get to pick who she wants to. Day after, basically. So yeah, we had that. Which was cool. I like Becky, so I was hoping. Crowd loves Becky. Like, we love her. And then we had Daniel versus AJ. Daniel won. We had Brock versus Finn. Brock won. For the men's Royal Rumble, we had Jeff Jarrett come. Johnny, Pete Dunne, Aleister Black. R-Truth was number 30. He came out, but got attacked. I had to look at this online because I didn't get to watch it because my power went out. And then they decided to come back when the pay-per-view's over, so I was kind of mad. Nia ends up coming out and attacking R-Truth, enters as number 30 in the men's Royal Rumble, and eliminated, Ali, I think is who it was, I didn't get to watch it. And then she gets an RKO from, Randy Orton is what I saw, so yeah. And then Seth ends up winning the men's Royal Rumble, so that was it for the men's Royal Rumble. I will insert pictures if I can find any from this, which I should be able to. So I'll insert picture because I don't think I can find any video clips online, and if I did, it was like really small. So, okay, so now on to Raw. I gave Raw a 5 out of 5 this week. It's very rare that they get a 5 out of 5 because it's been sucking. So, yeah. I'm gonna go ahead and get started on this. We had Seth come out and he was talking stuff and all that, and he was gonna announce who he was gonna be facing at WrestleMania. Then Triple H comes out and interrupts and blah blah blah, and basically talking about he has to make a decision tonight, well, in this case on Raw. So that, then Dean comes out and starts talking. I'll insert video clips on all of this, and then here, and then.
And now you have a decision as to who you are going to burn down at WrestleMania. She will make her decision tomorrow night on SmackDown Live, but you need to make yours right here tonight.
I always believed in you. I was the guy by your side that whole time. And we promised to come up to WWE and take over together. He tried to stop us.
Well, you gonna go down the brother route? Talk about the brother you stabbed in the back on the same night your other brother told the world he was fighting leukemia again? Is that where you're going with this?
I'm sorry, but this conversation doesn't concern you.
Everything in this ring concerns me.
Well, what's the matter?
Do you have to ask permission from your father-in-law first?
Dean versus Seth. Seth wins. Nia comes down and attacks Dean.
Oh, from behind, Nia!
Making a nasty habit.
Then we had Nia and Tamina versus Alexa Mickey. This is a qualifying match. Whoever wins is going to be entered into the Elimination Chamber match for the tag team title. Obviously, Nia and Tamina won that. And then we had Kurt versus Baron. Baron won. Hate him. Then we had Finn gets a new challenge, which was Bobby Lashley. I can't stand them. Then we had the Revival versus Zach Ryder and Kurt Hawkins. And then we had a live segment, and he was doing all this stuff, music, and then Jeff Jarrett comes out, and then Road Dogg comes out, and they sang their song, blah blah blah. That's not what it's called, but you know. And then we had Ronda, oh wait a minute, yeah, we have Ronda versus Bayley, a title match. I wanted Becky. But they did their thing, and then later on, once that was over, Ronda won, obviously. Becky comes out, and they were arguing, and her and Ronda, but basically Becky's going, and she was supposed to announce who she's facing at SmackDown, but she announced it at Raw, so it's going to be Becky versus Ronda Rousey at WrestleMania, which is probably going to be the main event, which is great because I like Becky. And Ronda's supposed to be leaving after WrestleMania, I think. So that means Becky will probably win that and have her moment. It's better than Charlotte. Sorry if this is moving. I'm on my laptop. My phone is propped on my laptop, so I'm moving. Sorry. So I insert a video clip. And then we had Braun versus Drew. Braun won. And then Brock was there. And yada, yada, yada. Seth announces who he is facing. Oh, Daniel Bryan and Rowan was there because he's supposed to be there to find out who Seth's going to be facing. And Seth is going to be facing Brock Lesnar at WrestleMania, which I did not see that coming. I thought it was going to be Braun and Brock, which would have made more sense. And then Seth could have been facing somebody else. I thought, Yeah, it doesn't make sense. I thought Braun would be fit. I don't even know why they took that out of the bang. But anyway, that is it for Raw. SmackDown, I would give it a 4 out of 5. I wasn't invested as much as I was for Raw, but we had a Becky and Charlotte match. I'm just going to go through this quickly. We had Becky out there cutting a promo and all that. Then Charlotte comes out and starts talking stuff. And then they get in a jumbo fight, which reminds me of Paige and Charlotte when Paige was on stage. And they had that little table thing and they got in a fight. So that's what that reminded me of.
Sucker Punch just set off the Queen. Oh, now Lynch battling back. So much deep-rooted disdain between these two.
And again, the injured leg coming into tonight after the Women's Royal Rumble match.
Now once again, taking down Lynch.
Anyways, we had R-Truth and Carmella come out, and basically R-Truth got jacked up, as he said, thanks to Nia, so he didn't really get to, but the McMahon family decided to give him another opportunity to face Nakamura for the United States title. Basically, R-Truth won that. Well, I was shocked, holy crap, and then he's a champ, and then Rusev got all jealous, comes out, and then claims he wants a match for the title, blah, blah, blah. Well, anyways, R-Truth still won that match versus Rusev, so R-Truth is still a champion, which I'm shocked. Like, I'm really shocked, but he deserved it. So, yeah. And then we had Rey versus Samoa Joe. We had Shane and The Miz. And all that. The crowd was happy and chanting stuff. They were like, you deserve it. You deserve it. And then The Miz's dad came out and said, I love you, to The Miz. Then backstage we had Mandy and Sonya talking stuff and all that, entering the Elimination Chamber, which obviously, and obviously another one that's going to enter it is Billie Kay and Peyton, obviously. I would be shocked if they didn't. They're like branded as a tag team, so obviously they're going to come and be in there. We had The Bar versus The Usos versus Heavy Machinery versus The New Day. For whoever's going to enter their Elimination Chamber match. And The New Day was eliminated. I'm going to say, I think it was The Usos that won that. I was looking it up. I forgot. I'm so sorry. Usos won that. I had to look it up. Sorry, guys. Sometimes I forget. Then we had Daniel Bryan and Rowan come out. Daniel Bryan was threw the title in the trash, and he has his new, basically, eco-friendly title. I'll insert a picture of it or video of it. It's like, wow. I mean, it's kind of cool, but wow. But yeah, that's pretty much it for this week's review. Sorry if this is awkward. I'm just trying to get this recorded for you guys, but yeah, that's pretty much it. 14-minute video. I thought it was going to be longer. Blah, blah, blah. But yeah, that's pretty much it for this week's review. Let me know what you thought about the pay-per-view and the after pay-per-view Raw and SmackDown. And was you disappointed on who won, who you wanted to win, who you wanted to enter the Royal Rumble. But yeah, that's pretty much it for this week. Thank you guys for watching. Please like, comment, and subscribe. and leave any questions you have in the comments below, and I will see you next week. Bye, guys. Oh, she's sweet but a psycho, a little bit psycho. At night she's screaming, I'm on my mind, out my mind. Oh, she's hot but a psycho, so left but she's right, though.